So I'll tell you a few words about myself. I don't know you, actually. I mean, I know some of you, I've seen some of you, but so I don't know what, are you most theorists or experimentalists? Are you from Italy? Are you master students, PhD students? Are you advanced students? Or can you say a few words? I'm just, you know, you don't need to all of you speak, but few people could speak just so they get an attention, they get an idea who I talk to. Go ahead. Okay. Okay. So did you start there in connection with the accelerator near Cape Town, or? Yeah. Okay. Anybody else? Go ahead.
My name is Mark from the ANS.
Okay. In theory, or sorry, not in structure or in reactions or
reactions.
Okay. Anyone else? All right, you're shy. Together. Okay, let's go. So. All right, so maybe a few words about myself. So I come from Michigan State University. I'll show you in a moment some images from there. So my name is Paolo Danielowitz. My email is danielowitz@nscl.msu.edu. I'm from Michigan State University. It's a large university in the Midwest of the United States. It's located in East Lansing. Let's see. So the location is more or less over here. So this is a so-called mitten or hand, a winter glove, as it is called. And oops. This is a site of a National Superconducting Cyclotron Laboratory. So in my email address, NSCL stands from National Superconducting Cyclotron Laboratory. And it's a laboratory which is located on the campus of a university. It's one of the largest nuclear facilities in the US, and because of its location on the campus of a university, it's a major training ground for students in nuclear physics, and about 10% of PhD degrees in nuclear physics in the US is granted by our laboratory. Now the from, let's see, let's just show you the building. The university is a so-called land-grant university. This is this comes from the mid-19th century period. There was an initiative to create a set of universities within the United States that would train sons at that time. Most males were being trained of farmers. And so the university specialized at this time in biology, in genetics. And this was again was going against the religious beliefs and also against the contemporary training, which was basically in Greek, Roman history, etc., which was not very useful for everyday work of farmers. So because of this, the university, so the way those universities were run, they were receiving land, and sons of farmers were cultivating that land and selling crops. And from sale of crops, they got money to pay the professors. So that's the history of the university. Because of this, the university has a lot of is a lot of land. And just to show you, so this is my normal path when I go to work or from work. So I go through forested areas, which all belongs to the university. Maybe to show you the layout of our laboratory. We have two cyclotrons that work in tandem and accelerate ions, directing it to the variety of experimental halls. The university has become the site of EFRIP construction, which is the largest construction in the US currently within low energy nuclear physics. So the price is $730 million. So this is largest low energy investment in low energy nuclear physics. Again, to show you some photos from there. So this will show the so-called groundbreaking. So we had officials from the US government, senators, university president, who are starting to digging, and the current situation, or not the current, this is actually a situation from few months ago. It's shown in this photo. So this shows you. This is the pit in which the accelerator lines are laid out, and this is actually along the axis of the accelerator, and the lines is the accelerator lines are lying like a snake. So they start in the bottom, then they go up and turn and up and turn, and finally they go out like on a helix. Each time the beam is more and more accelerated, and then it joins the the current existing facilities. One reason the Michigan State University was chosen as a site for this construction is that, again, because it's on the campus of a university, then we can train students for nuclear physics in the US. This is actually from August of last year. Currently, this is all covered, and you already have a building standing above the ground.